So what's up guys, I'm Mesh from TechMesh, and today I'm going to show you that how to find and fix memory leaks in Windows 10. Okay, memory or RAM leaks. So before getting started, I would suggest you to please hit the like button and also subscribe and hit the bell icon for more future videos like this one. So at first I will tell you that what is a memory leak. A memory leak is a misplacement of resource in a computer due to faulty memory allocation. It happens when a RAM location is not in use, remains unreleased. A memory location is not to be confused with a space leak, which refers to a program using more RAM than necessary. A memory leak on Windows 10, 8 or 7 system is said to have taken place when the memory is not just accessible and despite not being in use. Okay, so this is obviously a bad thing, and I will show you that how you can solve it, okay? So at first, what you need to do is, you need to just disable programs running on startup. So for that, just right click on here, okay, on your taskbar, and then here click on task manager. So in your task manager, just here click on startup. And then here you can see that I have all this app running in the startup. So what you need to do is, you need to just click on the app which is enabled, and then right click on here and click on disable. You need to disable all of them which is not necessary, okay? And the app can, the memory leak can also cause for old or aged software. If you are using old or aged software, then try to update your software or just try to get a better version or a replacement for that old app if there is no update available. So the next solution is clear page file at shutdown. Okay, so for that you need to here just type here, search for regedit. Okay, just type for regedit or regedit, whatever you say it. And then just open it, and here what you need to do is, you need to just here click on H key local machine, then here just click on system, and now in system search for current control set. As you can see, this is the current control set. So here click on control. So in control, just search for session. Okay, just go to S. As you can see, here is a session manager. Just search for session manager and then click on here. So here just click on memory management. So here you need to just open the memory management. Okay, as you can see, I have opened the memory management. So in memory management, here as you can see, clear page file at shutdown. Okay, you need to change it value to 1. Okay, just here double click on it, and then here as you can see the value is 1 0. You need to just change it to 1, and then you need to just click OK. Now what you need to do is, after this process, just close it and then restart your computer. And remember that your shutdown process will now take a little bit more time, but the thing is, your memory leak issue should be resolved. And this was the second method. If the second method doesn't work for you, then there is also a third method which is called disable superfetch. Okay, so I will show you this method. So in search bar, just search for services.msc, services.msc. As you can see, this is the services.msc. okay, just click on open. So here you need to search for superfetch, but the thing is, in Windows 10 it has changed to sys main. Okay, so if you are in Windows 10 in the newer version, then you should search for sys main, and if you are in Windows 7 or Windows 8, then you should search for superfetch. So if, as I am in Windows 10, so I will search for sys main. Okay, so as you can see that I have found the sys main here. And then here you need to just click on the sysmain or superfetch, whatever it is for you. Then right click on it and then click on properties. So here you need to just click on stop. Okay, so now just give it a time. And now what you need to do is, you need to just disable it. Just click on here startup type, and then here select disable. So then just click apply. and then click OK. So now after doing this method, then you should again restart your computer. The restart is necessary with, I would suggest to restart after every method. So by this time, if the first two method doesn't work for you, then I think this method will definitely work for you. So if it works for you, then please hit the like button. If you have any question or any suggestion, then let me know that in the comment section below. And please subscribe to my channel and watch my other videos as well. So I'm Mesh from TechMesh and I'm signing out.